The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II has been widely debated over since its first flight in 2006. By 2017, delays and cost overruns had pushed the F-35 program's expected acquisition costs to $406.5 billion, with a total lifetime till 2070 cost of approximately $1.5 trillion in then-year dollars, which includes operations and maintenance. The fighter had faced many criticisms, like not being maneuverable as Russian fighters, such as Su-35, and its top speed being limited to Mach 1.6, which is far slower than contemporary fighters like Eurofighter Typhoon. Another key drawback being pointed out by many is F-35 can carry only 4 AIM-120s internally, and the limited magazine depth of this modern fighter has become a concern. It's to be noted that AIM-120 AMRAAM, advanced medium-range air-to-air missile variants like AIM-120D, is at the forefront of American BVR, or beyond visual range, offensive calculus. But this is about to change with the Sidekick adapter. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how F-35 Joint Strike Fighter would be more lethal in air-to-air combat. Let's get into the details. F-35, being a fifth-generation fighter, is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. Its external structure is designed to deflect signals away from the emitting radar, which makes it hard to detect or track. This is done by having no sharp edges or protruding elements and having a smooth external curvature. Also, it has a coating of RAM, or radar-absorbing material, that reduces the number of signals getting reflected. F-35 has the lowest radar cross-section, RCS, of all the jets except the F-22 Raptor. Against X-band radars, it's stealthy from the front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from the narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, the limited reduction is achieved from direct front. Classified techniques have also been used to reduce the heat signature of F-35. This thermal profile management of the jet makes it difficult for the infrared or IR homing missiles to target it. While the F-35 is capable of carrying AMRAAMs on its external weapons pylons under its wings, however, the option to carry more missiles internally would preserve its stealthy profile. This is where Sidekick comes in. Lockheed Martin has designed a new weapons rack named Sidekick to enable the F-35A and C Lightning IIs to carry two more missiles internally. Sidekick adds a little extra weight, but enables each of the two weapons bays to carry three AIM-120s instead of the current two, for a total of 6 internally carried AMRAAMs. 6 AIM-120s, an increase of 50%, will be a major boost to the F-35's air-to-air capabilities, puts it at par with the F-22 Raptor in this aspect, and greatly enhances its overall lethality in the air-to-air combat arena. It's unclear, as of now, how much modification has to be done to the weapons bay and bulkhead. Sidekick is not compatible with the F-35B. This is because the Stovall F-35B variant, belonging to the U.S. Marine Corps, has smaller internal weapons bays on account of the lift fan that it uses to realize its Stovall capabilities. The first mention of Sidekick occurred during a Lockheed Martin media briefing back in May 2019. A Lockheed Martin spokesman explained to Aviation Week, "What we've done is essentially completed trade studies, design, and development of Sidekick. What's left to be fielded will be things like software integration, weapons separation testing, flight testing, and airworthiness testing." Also, speaking at the 2019 Lockheed Martin media briefing was the company's F-35 test pilot, Tony "Brick" Wilson, who explained, The extra missiles add a little weight, but are not adding extra drag. Wilson went on to add that Lockheed Martin is developing the Sidekick entirely on its own, using the company's own internal research and development funding. Wilson said, "Lockheed Martin has gone out of its way and developed this capability, and now we've let the Joint Program Office know that it's out there. It will be over to business development and other people to decide how and when it gets implemented. Lockheed Martin stands ready to help the customer implement it when they want." Since then, significant work has been carried out, and Sidekick is now a contracted feature under official development. Importantly, when Canada closed its deal to buy 88 F-35s in January of this year, Sidekick, as a feature, got confirmed. A senior Canadian defense official stated that Lockheed Martin's latest Lot 18 Block 4 F-35As will be delivered as part of the package. A graphic that the Canadian Ministry of Defense released, along with the announcement, noted Sidekick alternate mission equipment to enable carriage of 6 AIM-120 missiles internally, as part of alternate characteristics. Lockheed Martin has not yet announced a specific time frame for the introduction of Sidekick, but it's confirmed that the company aims to complete the Block 4 upgrades by 2029, assuming that there are no delays. The Ukraine-Russia conflict has shown how important it is to gain air dominance and suppress the enemy's air defenses. Russia has failed to do so, and this has resulted in massive losses in air and ground. The F-35 can infiltrate enemy territory that non-stealthy fighters can't due to its stealth characteristics, carrying 5,700 pounds of internal ordnance. Once air dominance is established, the F-35 can convert to so-called beast mode, carrying up to 22,000 pounds of combined internal and external weapons to decimate the enemy. So, Sidekick will play a crucial role when the fighter takes on the enemy in the early days of the fight. It's also to be noted that several new smaller air-to-air missiles are being developed, and with Sidekick, F-35 could accommodate even more of them. So it's evident that with Sidekick, F-35 is going to get a great boost in air-to-air combat capabilities.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.